Today we're going to talk about what sort of containers you can use to rear your monarch caterpillars. So I have some different containers here to show you. I prefer something that's fairly disposable because monarchs do get diseases sometimes. They're kind of like any animal. They'll get viruses, they'll get bacterial diseases. And if you have a bunch of caterpillars and they suddenly all kind of turn black and die, at that point you're going to want to discard that cage. That's why I like to keep to kind of cages that I'm not too concerned about just throwing away. So any sort of just resealable plastic container. This is one where I kind of cut open the lid and put a little bit of screen that can help to reduce humidity. I like this one. This is just a plastic shoebox and I cut out a part of the top and then I just hot glued some window screen in there. This is nice because it helps reduce the humidity in it, and plus it also is a good surface for when they're going to make their chrysalis. So the caterpillars will crawl up there and make their chrysalis. We were in the lab just in, you know, plastic cups that you get on a petri dish. So there's nothing really that fancy that you need. It just has to be something that you can clean pretty easily. In fact, this summer I just started using, this was a flower vase that I got some flowers in. I just put some saran wrap over the top to keep them from crawling out. So all you just need is something to hold them. If you have cats and things like that, I probably wouldn't recommend the plastic cup, but you just need something that you can clean pretty easily as you replace the leaves each day. And one thing that happens, like if it's a cage like this that I don't want to discard, and even if I haven't had any disease problems, I'll usually just, once I'm done rearing a batch of caterpillars through, I will clean it out well and then decontaminate it with about 20% bleach. I always like to keep caterpillars of about the same age in a container together. And then once they've made their chrysalis, I won't reuse that one for caterpillars until the monarch has actually emerged. I do that for a couple of reasons. One, the big thing is it helps me determine kind of how much milkweed I need to put in. Those caterpillars grow a lot from the tiny eggs to the big fifth instars. And if you've got them mixed together, you're gonna have the big caterpillars eating all the food before the little ones even get a chance. Plus you're kind of wasting a lot of milkweed. So I keep the ages together, and then sometimes I'll move them between containers and sometimes not. I prefer smaller containers for the small caterpillars just because they're so small and would be very easy to lose in a big container like this. In fact, they could probably crawl right through the top. So I prefer just to use smaller containers. Things like petri dishes are easy to purchase. Just make sure there's fresh leaf material. They've got a nice clean container and they will do what they need to do. Just let your caterpillars do what they want to do. I mean, you might think, oh, you need to eat, but they know what they're doing, so just let them do what they do, and they're gonna sit up there probably for a day or two before they finally weave a silken pad and make that chrysalis. So that's kind of